What's up, everybody? I'm Matt Gary, and in this episode of Coding with the Force, we're going to go over what variable scope is in Apex. Alright guys, so welcome back to this Introduction to Apex tutorial series where we learn the fundamental skills necessary to become a developer on the Salesforce platform. In this episode, we are going to go over what variable scope is. It's going to be a quick lesson. There's not an enormous amount to this, but it's important that you know what variable scope is, because if you don't, you're going to be super confused why, you know, some places you can access your variable and other places you can't and all that kind of stuff. So let's just go over what variable scope means. Basically, it means that your variable is accessible within a certain block of code, right? And there's really no better way to demonstrate that than me just showing you. So first things first, we'll create a variable. I've got this class that I've made, actually, that's called variable scope. You can do this with any class that you've created in your IDE or whatever you're working in. If you don't know what an IDE is, definitely go back a little bit further in this series where we go over what an IDE is and how to set it up. I'm working in IntelliJ and Illuminated Cloud, so that's what we're going with. Now, regardless of what you're working in, this will all be the same. Feel free to create a class, name it whatever you want. And the first thing I'm going to do is create a variable. So I'll just create a private string named class variable, and we'll set it equal to cool string. And then I'm going to create a method, which I know we have yet to go over what methods are and how to create them and all that kind of stuff. That's actually the next lesson after this one, so stick around and you'll learn all there is to know, or at least the majority of what there is to know about methods. But we're just going to create one really quick in here, and we'll make it a private void method scope. So I've got my variable called class variable up here, and I've got my method right here that I've created, all in this same class. Now, right now, if I wanted to access class variable, I can, because, and you know, if I wanted to set it to something else, say like Taco Bell, right? I can do that. It's fine. And that's because of the scope of this variable, right? So this variable is what's called a class variable, right? It's like it's a variable that's declared for the entirety of your class. So within this class here, anything that you make, you will have access to this variable, right? Because you declared it at the class level. You didn't declare it within a method. That said, if I was in method scope over here and I created a variable, and we'll just call this string method variable equals methods row. And then I tried to come down here and make yet another method. We'll make another method and we'll call it, just to keep it simple, method two. And we'll try to access method variable. You can see that it's not auto-completing for me, and it's already giving me problems. And that's because I don't have access to this method, because this method was declared within this, variable was declared within this method called method scope. And it's not accessible anywhere outside of this method, because that's where we declared it. And that's the scope of the variable. Basically, within this method, you can only access this variable that we declared within it. You can't go outside of it and just start, you know, assigning it new values, if I can keep my voice. And this goes even further, right? So if I made an if statement in here, which I know we have definitely not covered yet, and we just said if, you know, 1 equals 1, which I, you know, that's going to equal true, but I'm just doing something really simple to get the point across of what methods, or sorry, what variable scope is. And I declared another variable in here. We'll say string if statement variable equals hi or something. If I wanted to now access this outside of this if statement, I'm going to have problems. As you can see, I now have a problem, right? I can't access this variable that I made within this if statement. And that's because I declared it within this block, right? This if statement block is what it's referred to as. And because I declared this variable within this if statement block, I cannot access it outside of the if statement block. It's only accessible in here. And that's the scope of the variable. The variable's scope is for the length of, you know, whatever code you stuff within this if statement block here. So basically, the thing that you really need to be aware of is whatever brackets, right, whatever block or brackets you declare your variable in, your variable is going to be kind of locked down or scoped into those brackets, right? So as you can see, the brackets for the class, those are the highest level brackets or the highest level of scope. So anything that I declare within, you know, the confines of the class brackets, I can get everywhere within my code. If I declare it within the block of my method, I can only get access to that variable within the method. And if I declare it within the block of an if statement, I can only get access to that variable within the if statement. So it's just very important that you understand what scope, variable scope is, and how it relates to, you know, the blocks that you declare your variables in, or the, you know, the scope you declare them in. Because if you don't, you're gonna get a little bit lost and frustrated from time to time. Especially in the beginning. So know that this is a thing. Variable scope is very important to understand, and that the brackets that you declare the variable between kind of determine, you know, where you can access that variable within your code. So I think that ought to do it for this video. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward, but an important concept to know. And don't worry, there are ways to pass your variables beyond the scope of a method, but that's something we'll figure out a little bit further down the line in this tutorial series. So stick with me and we'll go over all those things. In the next episode in this tutorial series, we are going to go over what a method is and figure out how to create one, which we've done several times before, but I've not really explained what a method is and why it's important and all that kind of stuff. So I'll see you in the next episode where we go over method scope. But if you like this video, if you want to see more of this tutorial series, make sure to actually like the video. Hit subscribe if you want to stick around, and hit the bell if you want to know when the next video actually comes out. So that's it for this one. I'll see you next time.